Good evening and welcome to I Believe in Miracles with Dave and Patty Loggy. And I am hosting tonight with them. My name is Norma Nelson. Dave and Patty are joining us from North Carolina. I think they're with us right now.
Hello, how are you?
Great. How are you guys doing?
We're doing good. Nice to see your face.
Nice to see yours.
I miss you, even though it hasn't been too long yet.
I know. I know. I miss you guys, too.
So, well, we've had a great weekend in the Lord here in North Carolina. Ooh, I hope that picture's coming in better than it is from here.
You look nice and tan.
Oh, okay. We don't look fuzzy from there?
No. Maybe a little, okay. But not bad.
Okay, good. We had a miracle service at Awaken City Church in Greensboro, North Carolina. Oh, well, BHG and the healing service. So, praise God. A lot of people got healed throughout the whole weekend, not just the healing service. We had people that kind of came in here and there, you know, and whenever we get to see them, that's when we pray for them, because we don't like to see them in pain, of course.
Amen.
And we happened to be on the way here, and Dave said he wanted to stop at a Wendy's restaurant. And as we pulled up, he saw Hardee's, and he said that he was just led to stop there instead. So we went into the Hardee's restaurant, and of course, Dave is telling people, the two behind the counter, about miracles and about his life and stuff. And I asked the lady if she needed prayer. She said she had a hernia. So I prayed for her. And she felt the power of God. And then the young man that was behind the counter, he said, well, you know, I'm a Christian. He said, I'm saved. And he said, I got baptized the other day. And he said, now the only thing that I need is to get filled with the Holy Spirit. So, you know, before we were gone, he was. Fortunately, God made a way. There was no other customers in the store, nobody waiting behind us.
Amen.
I just reached over and I just grabbed his hand and I said, you're going to be right now in Jesus' name. And he looked a little awkward, like I'm at work, but okay. He closed his eyes and he just started speaking in tongues. So.
Aww.
Even at a Hardee's restaurant.
Amen.
So it was just a divine appointment. Praise God.
Did you get any food, Dave?
Yep, I was short on beef at that point. I needed a piece of meat. Wendy's.
And then they actually gave us extra food. I think they were trying to bless us.
Aw. That's awesome.
I ordered the $5 meal and I got an extra double cheeseburger and a hot apple pie on top of it.
All right. Full course. Yeah, appetizer, meal, and dessert.
For $5.
So tell us what's been going on there.
Well, I got to pray for a couple of people this morning. I was only at the office for part of the day, and I finished working it from home today. But I prayed for a lady whose son got hurt playing sports, and he tore all the ligaments in his left leg. I prayed with mom, but I'm believing that her son received the healing. And I know that God touched her because I could feel her kind of shaking too. So I'm praying. And then I prayed for another coworker that had a headache. She wasn't feeling very well. And afterwards she said, I always feel warm and tingly after you pray with me. Which is pretty awesome. Yeah. But, and I prayed, whenever I'm at work, it seems like there's always someone that needs prayer. One of our nurses wasn't feeling well. I laid hands on her. That was on Friday. And she felt better. She said her head was hurting her and she just wasn't feeling well. So God is, he's awesome.
Yes, he sure is. Like he just always shows up and just shows off.
Yeah.
And it's not that we have a showy God, but we just have a big God, and people need to know how big he is and what a blessing that he is and how he just really, wow. It's just hard to even describe.
It is.
Yes.
And even just little things. On Thursday, I'm a trainer at my job, so I was training a class, and there's an activity we do where people write down five things they want to accomplish in their life and five things that they're good at. Mm-hmm. And we talk about that because we're trying to help everyone have think more about the people that we are providing services for in relationship to how we are as people. And right. And how, you know, that they want the same thing. So anyway, one of my things that I wrote down was a goal that I had to be debt free. And I put hopefully within a year. Well, on Friday, I got a call from Rich Ripka. I hope you're listening, Rich. And and one of the things he just out of the blue spoke to me, and God says debt free in a year. So woo-hoo. I said, okay, I'm taking that for sure. But I mean, all I did was write it on a piece of paper and speak it to Amen. The people in the class and just that quickly. And you know, that's, I'd have to say personally, God's been doing a lot of things, just answering prayers and having people prophetically speak something back to me that has only been between me and the Lord. You know, so, I mean, God is just so awesome that he does that. And if you have any doubt that he's listening to everything you say, don't doubt it. Because he really is. He really is. And he really answers all of our prayers.
Yep, he sure does. And it just seems like whenever we go to a restaurant, you know, we're on the road all the time, that God puts certain people across our path. And the other night we went out, after the meeting, and I can't remember her name. We were at this restaurant with Dave Fox, and we got this waitress, and we always pray for him, you know, when we get our food. And I said, is there anything that you need prayer for? And she said, he just asked me that. Well, I didn't hear. Dave had already asked her that too, Dave Fox. And she said, well, I'm going to be moving. And so, yeah. And so we prayed for her. And then she came back later, and I said, are you filled with the Holy Spirit? And she's like, no. And so we prayed for her to get filled with the Holy Spirit, and she just felt all warm and tingly. And she kept talking to us. It's like, and she even said, I just don't even want to leave this table. I just want to stay here and talk to you guys.
Awesome.
Yeah, and I just, you know, I hugged her a couple times and just loved on her. And she just felt the love of God. And, you know, it's really cool because sometimes people are hurting people and they just need that love. And she had a lot of different family issues going on. And her mom was just not in a really good place. So, you know, she just needed somebody to love on her like her mom should be. So it's just cool when God puts us across people's path like that.
Fellowship with God never gets tiring. I mean, you know, people are getting a taste of the Lord for the first time, even if it's not the first time, but especially when it's the first time, you know, it's like you don't want to leave. And I never want to leave even now after this many years.
Amen. Amen. Yeah, we just really enjoyed her company too. And, you know, God was just doing a mighty work in her. We said, check out our website. And, you know, if you ever need prayer, call us. We gave her a business card, of course. And I just said, read the back when you get home. And so I just know God was doing a mighty work in her that night. So praise I was God. So glad that we went to the right place.
Praise God.
You know, it seems like wherever we go, God just puts people across our path. It doesn't matter where we are. He puts people across our path.
Well, and the more that you doing what God wants you to do, the more people he puts across your path and the more sensitive. It's like when you buy a new car and you think you've got this unique car that because you've never really noticed it on the road, right? But as soon as you get it, then you start seeing all these other cars. It's the same car. Well, I don't want to make it sound, you know, diminished, but with the Lord, when you start doing what he has called us to do and not ignore the people that he's putting in our path, he right. just keeps bringing more.
Yeah.
And you guys, I mean, it doesn't matter where you go. There's people that want to hear from God, and they don't even know they want to hear from God. But God tells exactly. you, and then they receive. But, yeah. you know, and I've noticed that with myself. The more I'm stepping out, the more opportunities there are to Amen. Pray for people. Because
oh, yeah.
that's where your focus is. That's where I want mine to be. And that's where you and Dave, that's where your focus is.
Yeah.
You're just looking. oh, there's another person. I'm sorry.
Oh, okay. You know, when we're at restaurant, it's cool because when we're in a healing service, we expect it to happen. Yeah. You know, we know that people are going to get healed. And, you know, it's, of course, that's cool too. No healing is ever, ever not good. It's always amazing. It's always God. When we're in a restaurant and God just gives me a word, like there was two guys sitting at the table next to us the other day, and I just went over and I said, excuse me. I said, I'm a minister. And I said, God just gave me a word. And I said, I just can't help it, but I just need to deliver it. Kind of looked at me like, oh, wow. And I said, God just tells me that he's just going to use both of you in such a mighty way. And it was just the look on their face. It just like lit them up, you know? And it's just really cool. It wasn't anything huge, and it wasn't hard to deliver, but you never know what God's doing. And yeah. so you just need to be obedient, and when he gives you something, deliver it.
What happened last night?
Which part?
The restaurant.
Oh.
We couldn't even get into the restaurant. We went to Panera.
Well, no, we went to that other one.
I know, we couldn't even get into the restaurant.
Yeah, there was a car accident. And so we always pray for people when we see an accident or an ambulance, of course. And we went into we pulled into the parking lot.
Oh.
And a lady that was with us, she said, hey, my daughter is coming to work. She should be coming pretty soon. And we pull in the parking lot. We were going to turn right. And she goes, there's my daughter getting out of her car right now. And I said, turn left. Dave was driving. And so we turned left. And so we went over, and she didn't know our vehicle, didn't know us. I'm like, hi. And I said, your mom's in the car with us. That is kind of funny. And then she rolled her window down, and she looked at us like, oh, okay. And so I said, well, can I pray for you? She had pain in her back. And so I prayed and the pain left. And then I said, are you filled with the Holy Spirit? And she said, no. And so I prayed for her and she got it just really quick. She had to go to work, so we didn't want to take time. But she got it and we drove away and her mom was just so excited. And
what she got so long ago.
Yeah, I said okay. that. Yeah, she got that. She received it. And her mom's like, you just don't know how much that means to me that she got filled with the Holy Spirit. And I'm like, oh, yes, I do. Yeah.
I do. They're going to Africa as missionaries, and they had to get their family and kids right. So they wanted to make sure everything was right, so they took that opportunity.
Yeah.
Today, man, I had to go. I kept seeing Habitat for Humanity. So you got one of them around here? And we weren't getting going. A lot of things were trying to stop us. The Suburban, we had too much stuff running while it wasn't, and it wouldn't start. So we had to jump it to get going. So we go down to Habitat for Humanity, and I see this lady selling boiled peanuts. I said, hey, do you have any Cajun? So she comes up to the door in the parking lot, and I talked to her about miracles, and her husband had arthritis, a lot of pain. So I step out, blast him, it goes. I said, anybody else? He says, yeah, there's a lady in the Habitat for Humanity. What was her name? Debbie. The Debbie was the peanut salesman, but the other lady was started with an A or something. And we finally found her. I had to go around the place about three different times, found her, and within 2 seconds, her knee was healed.
Amen.
Her knee was just, I said, I can go right here. Here's our website. Check out the LaDonna story. And everywhere we go, if you're just paying attention, you'll see somebody in need. It don't have to be a word, but when you get there, God will give you a word.
Amen. Yeah. Amen.
Just step out into what he has for you.
Amen.
We've had so many. Dave, we had four Daves around here. So Dave, yeah, it's fun now, but you know, yeah. Dave, there's four Daves ahead to go. The Dave Fox, he's very prophetic, so he really works good as a team. So because he'd give them a word, tell them about their life. Get out of the streets Sunday morning before church, they feed the homeless. And I think I prayed for five people that got healed. The first one, the lady deaf in one ear, and Jolly, you know, that's been that way for years. I said, it ain't going to be now. Why could? Bam. She's my ear popped, I can hear you. A couple of knees in the back got healed, and there was a lady that wasn't quite right in her right mind. And Dave's wife prayed for it. And she started changing.
Amen.
And she's looking at me like, when are you going to do it? I said, you're doing it. I don't need to do it. And she was like, wow. And her confidence went up. You should have seen Dave there. He's like, my wife is actually doing it now. And he says, you guys just wrecked us last time we were there. You just wrecked me. I can't go back. I just can't go back. You wrecked me.
Yeah, and I will be putting more of these videos on Facebook. I thought some of them were there, and they're not there. So I have a whole bunch of them I'm going to put on there from this last weekend.
Amen.
We had Meredy that we prayed for last time we were here. I think we were here in May. You guys remember? May or June? June. And we came back, you know. We just had this last weekend with the same people. And she said that we had prayed for her, and she had precancerous, and for the last
6 years.
Yeah, last 6 years, every time she went to the doctor, and she had to go like every 6 months, and they kept saying it was precancerous. Sometimes it would be a little bit worse, or sometimes it would be a little bit better. And she went in July, and she said, it's all gone.
Praise like, the Lord.
That is praise so cool. Lord.
That is awesome.
And she has a ranch, so we got to ride horses, but it was different than you think. They're English saddles, and horses that are trained English to the opposite of Western. Western horses, you can't touch their mouth or they stop. And these, you got to pull on their mouth to make them go. So it was like everything that I've done all my life was the opposite.
Dave just looked really uncomfortable sitting in that saddle. But, you know, we still had fun. I'm so glad we got to go.
Did you have to have your legs hanging over on just on one side?
No.
Okay.
That would have really been uncomfortable and really awkward. I made a mistake. I wore capris. I won't do that again. But we had fun, and we'll have to do it again. And we'll be more prepared next time. So, but we had a good time.
You'll be back in the saddle again, right?
Yeah, it's been a long time since I've ridden one. Probably 3 years. But Dave said it had been about 20 or 30 years since he'd ridden one. So,
wow.
Yeah. Hey, Ryan, can we do the LaDonna video when we come back from the commercial? Would that fit?
The new one.
Yeah, the new one that we've got on Facebook. And if you can't do it this one, we can do it when we come back the second time.
I can do it right when we come back, yeah.
Okay, that would be great. Okay, and when we come back, we're going to have Steve and Lisa Haggerty. They're here with us, so we'll see you back here shortly. Thank you.
Concept Studios. This is Webcast One Live.
If Tom Coates from Consumer Credit of America was your personal webmaster, Tom would filter out all bad debt emails. If Tom was your mailman, you'd never get any debt reduction junk mail. If Tom Coates was a lineman, he'd block any phone calls offering to reduce your credit card debt.
Hi, I'm Tom Coates with Consumer Credit of America, and we're still your best choice for credit counseling. We're local, we're accountable, and we can do more. You make the call when the time's right for you.
When it comes to competition, there really is none for Consumer Credit of America.
Drug and alcohol addiction slowly steals a person's identity, tearing away pieces of their life little by little until one day it seems like the hope of a happy future is gone and there's no chance of getting it back. Here at St. Gregory Retreat Centers, we can assure you that there is hope. Our unique approach to recovery begins with the understanding that the dysfunction and damage caused by addiction can be overcome, not just dealt with. Don't let another day go by. Call St. Gregory today.
I was hungry. I was thirsty. I was a stranger. I was naked. I was sick. To the least of these, Holy Spirit-led Ministries is a proud supporter of Impact Ministries International, changing the world together. Find out more at tstammen.com.
Hi, this is Andy Hainer of Full Speed Impact. And if you're like me, the message you hear of God's miraculous power on this program builds your faith and encourage you to step out and touch others with God's love. That's why I'd like to share with you some exciting opportunities that Dave and Patty have right now to carry the work of Holy Spirit-led ministries forward in the area of television media, as well as some crucial requests to go into other nations, including Cambodia, India, Africa, and South America, to equip the church and to win the lost with the power of the kingdom of God and the authority of the Lord Jesus Christ. That's why I want to encourage you to partner with Holy Spirit-led ministries. Go to their website right now at hslm.us. Click on the donate button to make a tax-deductible contribution, and you will be blessed as you partner with this strategic work to carry the gospel of the kingdom of God into all the world. God is moving right now. Go to hslm.us and partner with Holy Spirit-led ministries today and be part of that move.
Welcome back to I Believe in Miracles with Dave and Patty Loggie. My name is Norma Nelson. I am co-hosting with them tonight. And we are going to watch a video. It's LaDonna's miracle story.
Tell me what happened just now.
It got real warm and then it got hot. And it tingles. It still tingles. The pain went away. And I can move it like out and up and down like I couldn't move before. It doesn't hurt for the first time. It doesn't hurt.
And you're born again. You're going your way to heaven.
Yes, I am. I said the sinner's prayer and I'm on my way to heaven for the first time in 32 years.
You get to feel the presence of God go through you. She just got healed, born again, delivered, set free. She told me she was never going to walk again. And now, see if you can make sure everything works. Test it out. We don't want any of this fake stuff.
It doesn't hurt when I walk.
Of course. Go for it.
Like, bro, I just command you to grow right now as the normal.
Look at it go. It's
keep
going.
Coming.
Look at it go.
There we go. There it is.
What do you think of that?
It is so
clean. Yeah, it is. Of course it is because it grew out.
You just got a hip surgery and a leg lengthen. What do you think of that? Go for it.
Like, bro, I just command you to grow right now as the normal.
Look at it go. It's
keep
going.
Coming.
Look at it go.
There we go.
You got no pain. You got a long leg now.
Now put your hand on your hip and just repeat after me. I command. New body parts.
New body parts.
Now. In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
And what's it feel like?
It's still all tingling, like, and hot.
No, of course.
Like hot, all the way down my leg.
That's the Spirit of God in you. See, all we do is we agree with heaven. Heaven wants everybody healed, set free, born again. But religious people hurt. They beat you with a Bible and tell you how bad you are. Jesus never did that. You just got adopted into a new family. That's why I gave you my card and my phone number. So if you ever need... Don't know what else to pray for. It's like a hot line right to the throne.
And you know, whenever I feel so free like this, like I don't, I feel like all the weight is just gone.
It's gone. It is. That's because it is gone.
You're right.
Wow.
You look lighter.
I feel so much better. Like I can breathe, and it's not so heavy. You know, I'm not worried about tomorrow.
That's actually what you just said is scripture.
Really?
You got the Bible in you. You got the whole Bible downloaded like you do to the computer. God just did a zip drive.
That's so cool.
You didn't have to read and study it. And when you need it, he's right here.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't feel alone. So scared and lost.
Well, that's because he's hanging out inside you.
And he said he will never leave you.
Amen.
Never leave you. Never.
And how long is never?
Never. Never happened
to me. I would like you just to say what happened to you this morning.
I wound up at the grocery store not knowing why he bumped into this bed. He prayed for me through the pain. My hip doesn't hurt anymore. And my leg grew. And it's still all tingly. Not. And then I got saved.
And you got adopted?
I got adopted.
And you know God loves you.
And God loves me.
And them aren't you're not sad?
No, not at all.
You're crying joy?
Yes.
That's so good. It's been about a month since the Lord grew your leg out. Tell me, what is happening in your life now?
Well, all night, that whole rest of the day and then that whole night, my leg had this like tingly hot feeling. And when I had woke up in the morning, it was gone, but I noticed I didn't hurt. At first, I didn't notice that right away. And then I was getting things together to get ready to go with my day. And I noticed I got on my bike and I lifted my left leg up and got on my bike. And I've never done that before. It's usually I stand on the left and lift with my right. And I was riding and it didn't hurt. And so I had to go to the doctor's that day. And I went down to my orthopedic appointment. They were gonna do my pre-op. And I told my doctor, I said, you know, maybe you should take some more x-rays, I said, because God healed me. And he said, oh, stop with that, LaDonna. And I said, no, I'm serious. I said, I don't hurt. I said, I think you need to take x-rays so we don't go in and do something for no reason. So he took some x-rays. He didn't want to, but he did, and took the x-rays, and he came back 30 minutes later, him, and it was his, the little guy that's under him that's trained to be the doctor too.
Right, his PA, his physician assistant.
Right, and they came in and they were just amazed and they said, I don't know how this happened. And I said, what? And he said, you're fine. He said, it's a total hip, it's real, there's no hardware, all the hardware's gone and everything. And I said, it's a God thing. I said, I told you he healed me. And I've been going strong ever since. I can run, I can jump, I can sit Indian style, I can ride my bike and I can walk. And it doesn't hurt at all. There's no pain. I can move it. I can kick with my left leg if I want to kick. It's a great
thing. I'll be nice.
And then also, me and my dog were homeless. And God made a way for me to get a house. My state money had finally came through, and I had been fighting this for 6 years. and it came through, and we're moving into our house today. Little one bedroom house, me and my dog are our own house. And he's taken a lot of the mental stress that I carried and mishaps with my family and my life that has made everything go so wrong. But today I don't burden, it's not a burden on me, and I feel so much happier, and I'm free, and I laugh, and I love people, and people like me, and it's a great feeling to know. And I just want to give all the thanks to God, because He does love us, and He is real.
That it's been a pleasure to call you friend.
Yes, you guys are not just my friends, you guys are my family.
Well, that is exactly.
I'm so grateful and thankful that God put you in my path.
Well, do you want to say hi to Dave and Patty?
Hi, Mom, hi, Dad. I miss you guys. You have to come see. I can run.
Praise God. I could watch that over and over and over again. That just blesses me every time. God is so good.
You can hear us, can't you?
Yep, I can hear you.
Okay. Yeah, it's amazing. We just had Zoe redo that for us, and it's just so cool.
Yes.
That he got that fixed for us. And can you see us?
No.
Okay. Okay.
Well.
Now you can see a picture of us?
Yeah.
Okay. It says call with something. So I don't know which button to push. Can you tell me which one? That's not the right one. Sorry, guys, we're having technical difficulties.
In the name of Jesus, everything come together right now.
Amen. Can you call us again, Ryan?
It's the camera.
Oh, there's the video. I don't know why it doesn't just come on all the time. Okay.
There we see ya.
Okay. There, we have Steve and Lisa now. But, yes, that video with LaDonna is just amazing. Every time, it doesn't get old. You know, we've got it. Zoe did it and put it all together, and it just turned out great. He did a wonderful job for us, and we just appreciate all his help and what he's doing. And we just appreciate what God did with LaDonna.
Amen.
So, Steve and Lisa Haggerty, they're the regional directors for what area do you call it?
Eastern Region Zone 3, or I just say Southeastern Region.
Oh, okay. Okay. So we've been with them for the last few days. What day did we come? Thursday. So we started out with a Thursday night training session, and it's just been amazing time. So many different people got healed. Can you tell us some of them that you can remember?
Mary.
Your daughter?
Oh, Sarah, my daughter. Her wrist got healed while she was praying for someone else.
Amen.
We had so much at this time. We'd have a tough case, and we'd get them to pray for somebody else, and they'd get healed of what they needed while they were working on somebody else.
Amen.
Yeah. And we just had them praying for each other, and, you know, that's what, when she was getting prayed for, it was getting better and better. And then I said, switch around. You pray for her now. Because she'd gone through the training. We wanted to get him activated. And so she prayed for her. And when she was done praying, I said, how's your wrist? And the look on her face was just like, wow, it's gone. Pain's gone. Like, yeah, praise God. So, and what she got, tell us what happened with somebody else that she prayed for.
for the baptism of the Holy Spirit?
Yeah.
Yeah. It's the second time that she got to pray with someone for the baptism of the Holy Spirit.
Yeah, that's cool.
She got to help her husband receive the Holy Spirit, which was really a blessing to her.
Oh, cool.
Believe me, I tried. I tried. I put everything into that one. I guess it took a soft touch.
Oh, funny. So do you remember anyone this weekend?
Did you already talk about Stefan?
No.
Oh, Stefan was one of the people going through the DHT training, and he got up, and they brought him up front, and he prayed for some for another person there, and they got healed. And then he told us that, which he didn't tell us before, but his back or and his neck were hurting him, and he got healed at the same time.
Amen.
When he blasted the, well, you know, prayed for or blasted the other person. And it was really funny because on Waken City goes out and they feed the homeless at 8 o'clock Sunday morning before they have their normal service. And I went out there, or Dave was already out there, and a lot of the people from the church were there, and Stefan was there. And so I went up to him and talked to him and just was blessing him and encouraging him. And all of a sudden the thought comes to me, you have the Holy Spirit? and I asked him, and he said, yeah. But, and I said, do you speak in tongues? Because, you know, sometimes you get that little check, you know, when they said they're filled with the Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
And the Holy Spirit says, well, almost. And so right there on the street, I just gave him some instruction and, you know, for teaching from the Word, showed him there's a difference between being born again and having the Spirit of Christ with you and actually being filled with the Spirit.
Right.
And after he understood that, well, I said, can I pray for you? And he said, sure. So right there on the street, downtown Greensboro, in Greensboro City Park, I prayed for him, and he spoke in tongues. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And I told him, went over to Dave and told him, hey, Dave, I just got Stefan filled with the Holy Ghost. You mean he didn't understand the badge and the gun? I was talking about that all the last 3 days. And I said, oh, well, you know, he's filled now. So, and that was really pretty interesting, too, because Dave brought that, used that point later on in the day, because we had a few more hours in Sunday afternoon to finish the DHT.
Yeah.
And he said, look, Stefan prayed for somebody, I think it was Saturday, got them healed, and he got healed, and he didn't even have the baptism of the Holy Spirit yet.
Amen.
So there you go. If you have, if you're a son in the family of God, you can get people healed. But it was so cute. I thought that, you know, if Dave would have come on, I said, well, I should have said to him, well, he didn't have his boots and his cowboy hat on either. But, you know, you got to have the whole outfit, I guess.
Oh,
I
don't
know. Full armor guy.
Full armor guy, that's it.
We got the John Wayne full armor guy.
But anyways, I thought that was so cute when I went over and seen Dave's reaction. It's like, I would have taken care of that.
We have to ask somebody 3 days in a row, you know, and they, oh, no, there's nothing wrong. There's nothing wrong. I'm okay. But your back got healed and your neck got healed. You know, there was 3 days before that when I asked them, anybody had any pain? Didn't you comprehend that? And you get some of the funniest answers. Like, well, you know, I really didn't want to, yeah. With one lady, I kid around with them, there's twins. And they're identical twins. And it's hard to tell them apart unless they're standing next to each other. And she says, well, I don't know if I hurt or not. I said, did your toe hurt? She says, no. I got ready to stomp on my boots. What are you doing? I said, well, I wanted you to know the difference between hurt and not hurt.
Well, one of them, Jessica, one of them is what? Marissa. Okay. Oh, they're so cute. I went to hug one. And she wasn't the one that was there the day before, but I had met her last time we were here. And she gave me a great big hug, and after I hugged her, I'm like, you're not Jessica, are you? She goes, no, and I knew you didn't know that. I knew you thought I was the other one, but she goes, that's okay, take the hug anyhow. They're so cute.
Yeah. Well, don't feel bad. It's taken me, what is this, 8 months to figure out the difference between the two. So.
Amen. Well, I guess we have to go to a commercial. So we'll talk to you in a few more minutes, Norma. Thank you.
All right. See you guys back in a minute.
All right.
From the RE/MAX Real Estate Concept Studios, this is Webcast One Live.
I'm Brian Leach, owner and general manager of Service Legends. Oh, I brought along a couple of the home comfort heroes.
Hi, I'm Tammy Wells.
I am Nick Wondershot.
I am administrative manager.
I am the senior technician
from Service Legends.
It seems like every good thing, when you feel it to the bone that it's good, there's a lot of hard work put behind it. I don't think that you can fake it and have it turn out good.
You know, if we seem like, okay, that's just weird, it's just a furnace, why would you believe so deeply in a furnace? It's not just that, you know, we want to show the world that you can have good service.
Yeah, I mean, it's gotta be, it's your home.
You know, it's built into our daily trainings, it's built into our culture, that we're gonna do whatever it takes to have each client say they love us, period.
That's why we spend all the hours in the training that we do. And if we guarantee it's gonna be a good experience for you, or else it's free, what type of work do you think we're gonna do?
There is a guarantee.
Temperature selection guarantee, fixed rider it's free guarantee, comfort guarantee, best value guarantee, all of these guarantees hold us accountable to ensuring that we exceed your expectations. And if for whatever reason we'd fail and we can't make it right, we guarantee all of those guarantees with 100% money back guarantee.
I mean, if you don't think that your technician can fix it right, are you gonna say that to a client? No.
You don't have to worry about having a technician come to your house.
We drug test, background check all of our team members. We put safe people in your home. Each and every one of our service techs, 400 hours a year in training.
You tell it the minute they walk in the door. They know what they're doing, they've done their homework, and they actually truly care about what you want.
Because at the end of the day, you're the person that makes sure I have a job.
They're going to be listening. They're going to want to know what your challenges are. Then they're going to come and give you options, and you get to choose.
If I'm there to help and I make it easy and painless, I did my job right that day.
Well, when it comes to your comfort, safety, and your family, you know, you don't necessarily go buy the most expensive, but you get the most bang for your buck.
Oh, it's worth it, because there's a lot of people that will find a way to get it to work right now and then leave and then come back, charge you again, and the cycle just repeats itself. So when I'm out there looking at the furnace, I want to find why it failed today. How can we change the part today with something that you're not going to have to worry about? Is it worth changing the part today? I mean, you can put a lot of money into a furnace. I can fix parts all day. There's good job security in that for me. But is it the right thing for you?
I get a lot of the phone calls of after the technicians are there. They're just in awe. They're like, wow, you guys are great. I mean, I don't even know what to say. You guys are great. Everything you did was perfect. It was great.
Keep going, though. I like this.
Just give us a try. I'm going to take all the risk.
I've got the time to make this right. I've got the support to make it right.
Just check us out.
And if you don't see the value in what we do,
I mean, fixed rider, it's free or 100% money back.
Enough said.
If your knowledge of the Word of God exceeds your obedience to the Word of God, you're backslidden. I don't care how excited you are.
Let me ask you something. Is the Fivefold Ministry really equipping you? Because to me, it looks like they're just exploiting you.
What do you mean you don't have faith? What have they been feeding you all these years? After we're finished training you, you won't have to chase anointings anymore. You'll walk in the one you've got.
Hi, this is Andy Hainer of Full Speed Impact. And if you're like me, the message you hear of God's miraculous power on this program builds your faith and encourage you to step out and touch others with God's love. That's why I'd like to share with you some exciting opportunities that Dave and Patty have right now to carry the work of Holy Spirit-led ministries forward in the area of television media, as well as some crucial requests to go into other nations, including Cambodia, India, Africa, and South America, to equip the church and to win the lost with the power of the kingdom of God and the authority of the Lord Jesus Christ. That's why I want to encourage you to partner with Holy Spirit-led ministries. Go to their website right now at hslm.us. Click on the donate button to make a tax-deductible contribution. and you will be blessed as you partner with this strategic work to carry the gospel of the kingdom of God into all the world. God is moving right now. Go to hslm.us and partner with Holy Spirit-led ministries today and be part of that move.
Welcome back to I Believe in Miracles with Dave and Patty Loggie. And I am Norma Nelson, co-hosting with them tonight. They are joining us from North Carolina. And are you there?
Yeah, we sure are. Hey, we're going to pray right now. So if you want to start off, then Lisa's going to jump in, and then Steve's going to finish up. So whatever the Holy Spirit puts on your heart, Norma.
Okay. In the name of Jesus, by the power of the Holy Spirit, I speak life and light to Murfetta, to your son. Let all of those ligaments and everything in his body be healed now in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Lord, we just thank you for this ministry, the blessing and the opportunity that we've had to learn and grow under it has been amazing, and it's changed our lives and the lives of others, and we're just so thankful for that opportunity. It's not just that we hear and sit, but we hear and do when we go. And we just thank you for that opportunity.
Right now, we speak to everyone who is discouraged and not seeing the results or our answer to prayer. We just speak to you encouragement. We speak to you life in the name of Jesus. We set you free from depression, discouragement now in the name of Jesus. And we release the life of God to give you courage and peace and to rise up as a mighty son or daughter of God and receive your blessing now in the name of Jesus. We also call forth those that are into this message to be laborers alongside of us.
Amen.
Right now in the name of Jesus, we just release life. We release them from any oppression. We release them from any religious attitude. We set them free now in the name of Jesus. And the life of God, Holy Spirit, draw them to this message. Draw them in. Those co-laborers that are to labor with us here with this word and this message, setting the captive free, we receive them into this, and we believe that you are leading and drawing them to this message, and we call them in now in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name, everyone that's listening to this broadcast, be healed in Jesus' name. Life.
Yeah.
Life. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Well, Steve, you said you remembered some more from this last weekend. We'll let you tell us what you've got.
I think this weekend I pray for more people to receive the Holy Spirit than I think probably my entire life before that. And the beautiful thing about it is they receive. Hallelujah. So that was a great encouragement to me. And
amen.
It was a blessing to see Dave Roth, about 10 people, right at the beginning of Sunday morning service, and he blasted him. And it just so blessed my heart, you know, to see them receive. And a few of them were tough cases, but it was a blessing to me to see his example, how he wouldn't quit. And he just kept on blasting them and just would not allow that devil to keep oppressing him. And that was such an encouragement to me. And a good example for me to follow. And I thought that was great. And he passed the back, he brought a few of them, directed them back towards us. And I got to pray for one young man whose ankle was still bothering. He wasn't quite 100% yet. And, you know, I got to blast him. And then all of a sudden, you know, Holy Spirit speaks again. Do you have the Holy Spirit? I love it. This is beautiful. It makes it so easy. When you understand that Holy Spirit is with you,
yes.
It's a team effort. He needs your actions and he needs you to direct your intentions, but also to speak and to ask the questions that he needs to ask the people that are in front of you. So I just love it. I love listening to him, and I love acting upon what he says. And it's just so beautiful that time after time, he just confirms it. The people in front of you confirm it. And so I got to pray with that young man, and he received the Holy Spirit and spoke in tongues. And it's just a blessing. And of course, you know what happened. The rest of his ankle was manifested, and he was completely healed. The last little bit was taken care of. So.
Amen.
And, I got to pray with another young lady, a teenager, and this has just blessed me because I received the Holy Spirit when I was 16 years old, too, as a teenager, and she was so shy, kind of reminded me of me, you know, at that time. But anyways, I got to pray for her. Her parents were there, you know, I got to pray for her dad and then pray for her mom. And then I went to her because, well, she's standing there too. So she's up front. You all get it, right? They all need something.
Yeah.
So I went ahead and was praying. And all of a sudden, your Holy Spirit said again, do you have the Holy Spirit? Oh, he knows them so well, doesn't he?
Yeah.
But I got to pray with her and she received, and her parents were just, you could see, and they were grinning from ear to ear because she spoke in tongues and received the baptism of the Holy Spirit. So.
Amen.
And of course, you know, you can tell I'm reliving it right now again. It's just a blessing to be able to work in union with God, you know, work in union with the Holy Spirit. And just the confidence knowing that he's there by your side, you know, they're ministering with you. What a tremendous blessing to know that and have the confidence that the Holy Spirit, the same power that raised Jesus from the dead, the same one who has completed and done all these other miracles year after year, you know, and even created this whole thing, you know, it's just a blessing to know that he is there with you and you're not by yourself. So anyone out there ministering and having a little struggle with this, with getting the message operating, just remember you're not alone. Holy Spirit,
amen.
The power of God, the person and power of the Holy Spirit is working with you. Amen. You are not alone in this. So be encouraged today. Go ahead. Keep pressing in, knowing that Holy Spirit's got your back. You're one, and you're going to see the results that you desire to see, because Holy Spirit wants the same results too. Amen?
Amen. Yeah.
Amen.
Don't give up. Just keep going, pressing forward. And you know what? It has to break. There's no other choice. Sometimes it's hard. We think, I can't keep doing this. It's just not working like I want it to. But just keep going. It will. It will.
Don't quit. Don't stop. Just keep hitting it and hitting it and hitting it, and it will leave.
Amen.
Guaranteed. You got God's word on it, not my word on it. The word of God says that if you don't stop, you win.
Amen.
Amen.
Yeah.
That's the key to this whole ministry. If you don't stop, you win.
Amen. There was a Meredith. No, Jessica's sister. Meredith. Yeah. Is she the one that doesn't have the freckle on her face, or the one that
does?
No,
Marissa.
Okay, it was Marissa. I asked for her testimony, and I'll have it on my Facebook here shortly, but it was so cool because she said, you know, last time you guys were here, she says, you guys kind of really, it was hard to receive. She said it was like, blowing your box apart, you know? And, oh, goodness. Well, I guess you can still hear us. And she said that she just didn't quite know how to understand and to grab it all. But she said this time, she said she just kind of, she got it a little bit more and more and more. And she said it just shifted her whole view. And she really grabbed the whole thing. And I said, well, it's not really healing. And she goes, yes, it is. She said, it was actually a spiritual healing for me because I just really grabbed the whole thing. And she, her and Meredy are going to go out together and pray for people. And she goes, she kind of pushes me. But she said, it's a good thing. Yeah. I said, yeah, it is. I said, it's great. I said, you guys need to go and do this. Step into it. I said, if you don't do it now, then you're going to have a hard time. You need to step into it right away and go ahead and just go to Walmart, go to the park, wherever you're at. You're out to eat. Pray for your waitress. And, you know, it was just so neat because it wasn't the same kind of healing, but it was a healing. Mm-hmm. And to her, it was so big. It just helped put everything into the way it's supposed to be. She said, I always knew God, but it was like there was something that I was missing. Mm-hmm. There was just something out there. And she said, I could never put my finger on it. But now she has a different relationship with God than she ever did before. And so that was really encouraging for me to hear that, you know, it really changed her life like that. And Stefan, he just really grabbed a hold of this. He's the one that got filled with the Holy Spirit later. And it was that got healed when he was praying for somebody else. He just really he really grabbed a hold of this too, and he is really going to be a mighty man of God. And I'm looking forward to hear new and more things about him and from him and what he's going to do in the Lord. And God just reminded me this next Wednesday night, actually, we're going to be in South Carolina at Columbia at Christ Central. So if you are in that area or you know somebody in that area, let them know about the DHT we're going to have. It's on our website, all the details, so check that out. And we have other ones coming up, so check out all the different things we have going on. We're going to be in Vancouver, but that's changed from October to the first week in December. So God's just moving us all over the place and just opening the doors. We have one coming up in Missouri and Arkansas, so Delaware, check it out. Delaware, September 18th. Okay. And so, that's like 5 days. So if you're in that area, come. It's going to be all 5 nights of healing services, and we're going to do a DHT in there also. So that is going to be great. God is just moving and shaking things up, and praise God, we're just going to go all over wherever it opens the door, and we just look forward to teaching more people so they can lay hands, and they can do it, and they can do it, and they can do it, but it just keeps spreading, you know, like Jesus in that movie Pay It Forward, but it just keeps spreading all over.
Amen.
You got, honey? You got something, Steve?
Well, it's so easy. When you make it down to the simplest thing, I'll take my car keys and I'll put it in somebody's hand. And I said, what are you going to ask God for? He said he gave it all to you. So they give me this dumb look. He's like, what do you mean? I said, well, you only got all power and all authority. So quit asking God to do what he told you to do.
Amen.
If you had a son or a daughter and you told them to take out the garbage every Wednesday, and every Wednesday you said, hey, Mom, hey, Dad, I want you to do it. Would you be happy with them? Our Father in Heaven the same way. He said, you go heal the sick.
Yeah.
I don't know how that is not understood, but he told the first 7, the first 12, the next 70, all believers to do that. And we'd actually do what Dad says, our Father says, we could get this over with and go home. I don't know how.
Well, let's go get it done.
It takes a theologian to twist that one. The little kids can understand it. He said, become like a child. Not like a theologian. Don't come like a Pharisee. Come like a child. Just only believe.
Amen.
Well, the kids are so easy. You tell them to go do it, and people's thumbs grow back.
Yep. Amen. They do. They get it done. Well, we do want to say thank you to Pastor Frank and his church for having us, and Steve and Lisa. We've had a great time, and we're going to continue. Steve's going to be with us in Delaware, aren't you?
Yeah.
So we're going to have a good time there. And we want to thank you, Norma, for holding down the fort for us. And just wherever you go, we know you're going to touch people's lives. So
you're welcome. Right. Thank you for letting me be a part of what you do. And yeah. Thank you, Lord.
Your singing ability, too. So I say, if you guys get more people, we'll be able to bring more. We'll bring our singer with us.
Yeah, I'm hoping you can go with us to Missouri because it's not going to be such a long trip. So
okay.
I told them about you today. So check it out. See the date. See if you can go with us.
All right. What month is it in? I'll look on the website.
Okay, see things going on. Praise God, let it just continue in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Yeah, oh yeah, I think it is in November, the first weekend. But yeah, and we just want to thank Ryan, our producer. He does a great job. We know we stretch him. That's all we ask him, but we appreciate it, Ryan. And Michael, he does our website. He's just such a blessing to us. So, and Jeff, he's always helping out in one way or another. So praise God for everything that everybody's doing. And thank you for people that have donated into our ministry. We really appreciate that. And I hope to see you all soon. And most of all, we want to thank God because that's where it all comes from. Amen. He's the one that helps us do what all we get to do. So thank you, Jesus. And See you next week, same time, same place. God bless.
God bless you guys.